I'm really not pleased with how bad it is, but I guess more than that, just about the park. I was called into the attorney general's office. I work for the welfare reform office. I take a lot of time and I work over there. And the attorney general wanted to speak to me on a recent local news interview I had done regarding pre-made homicide. In the interview, I stated that it was not feasible to offer pre-made homicide there. So they sent a piece of Dr. Clark an email along with a copy of that video saying that they disagreed with what I said. So I met with the attorney general. We went over the statute. It's the law statute 1357-16. It's very clear. If you have a homicide victim, it's mandatory according to the design of permanent agreement. So they did agree with me that I was correct in my statement. But my question is, according to the state law of records, and he said you had, you know, violated that statute over 150 times, I would like to know why you felt that you needed to report me to them. They need to straighten me out.
I did not speak to anybody at the attorney general's office or shoot a video.
They have the email along with the copy of the video, but they showed it to me and came from your office.
They videoed me saying something?
No, they said, you said, your office said the clip of the news article with my interview, and in that interview, I stated it's malfeasance in office when you cremate homicide victims, they should have permit. But what I'm about to say is you have done that over 150 times since you've been in office. And I was personally like, probably had a permission.
Well, I don't recall or know of any email that I sent to the attorney general's office that you referred to.
Well, you want to ask why you cremated over 150 homicide victims?
Well, I think after we've done a complete forensic exam, we've obtained all the forensic evidence that's necessary, and if the family wishes to have that final disposition, then we're done with our part of the exam.
You don't feel like you removed the defense's opportunity to defend himself? Because we had one case, I know, of an East Battery parent partner becoming coroner, that a man claimed he shot and killed. He was accused of shooting and killing someone. He said, no. He said, I shot him, but I didn't kill him. He was already dead when I shot him. He said, well, how did he die? And he was strangled to death. So the coroner had to leave the body to the funeral. So they had to go get the body back and re-examine the throat area, because then they proved the victim actually was indeed dead prior to him being shot. So they couldn't arrest the guy for murdering somebody when they already dead. So there's times I believe that you removed the, you destroyed the evidence in a case for the defendant to defend himself.
So you asked me to make a comment about a case before I was cornered. So
I said,
I feel like it's necessary once I've collected all the forensic evidence that we can proceed with whatever the family wishes are.
So,
I've answered the question.